Hi ladies, welcome back to my channel for advice. Today is Monday and it's a public holiday here in USA, and I've been home relaxing, just catching up with errands and just, you know, nothing special. I wanted to talk today about the subject perhaps some viewers or YouTubers might find interesting, because I was watching a TV show and I just, you know, I was thinking, and my thoughts went from one to another, and I said, you know what, maybe I should talk about this. The subject today, and by the way, don't forget that this is an open subject, which means it's for all of us to talk and discuss, not just for me. I can just put the subject forward, and please come up with answers, questions, or even ideas and suggestions, so that the person who is in trouble and who is trying to find this advice channel on YouTube, if they find us, they will actually not just listen to me but also read all the advice given. And by the way, the previous person who had emailed me was very grateful and very happy with all the advices that everybody else gave, and my advice too. So it's kind of, I'm glad we were able to you know, suggest some good ideas to someone who had this special question. Today the question is, why women who are abused continue to stay in that negative relationship or marriage? A lot of women are often abused and they continue to stay, and maybe you know someone like that around you, or maybe you have met someone in your life so far who has been in a situation like that, and perhaps you even try to warn this person or advise this person, try to get them out of that marriage, but they keep staying in there and you cannot understand, and perhaps you give up. You say, okay, you know what, I told you so many times to, you know, leave out, get out of this marriage, but you don't want to, so what can I do? I just have to be there for you, I guess. So basically, there are many reasons why a person stays in a marriage that is negative, abusive, where the husband is like a bully and he is all continually abusing this person, his wife. The woman usually stays because she has extremely low self-esteem, and she cannot believe that she can live without him. She is in denial. Often she thinks she cannot live without him, either financially or emotionally. Women are emotional beings. Before anything, they need to know that a person is loving them. So maybe they want to believe that this husband or boyfriend is loving them. And even though he might be, according to them, harsh on them sometimes, but they think that it's worth to stay because they have the love of this person, which could be something completely distorted, nothing far from the truth. Because if a person is showing you disrespect, treating you like a rug, walking all over you, then how can you say that this person is loving you? If you love a person, you should treat them with respect and love them, really love them, but not abuse them, yell at them, hit them, or do whatever else that is degrading to any woman. So another reason why women stay in this negative relationship is because poverty. Some women are very poor, they have no jobs, they have no, they have never worked perhaps in their life, and they think that the breadwinner, the husband or the boyfriend, is the person that they are depending on. That without this person they will be out on the street. Now another reason also is because often in situations like that, it's possible that the woman has put a lot of energy and care and money in this relationship, and she does not want to get out of the marriage because she knows that she's going to lose half of everything, or even everything sometimes, things that she has worked very hard for. And that is one of the reasons why often women continue to stay in a bad marriage, even though they know very well that that marriage has ended long time ago, that there is nothing connecting them to each other than the financial part, that they don't want to give up, which also is something, you know, not really good at the end of the day. When the day comes and you are old, you're gonna think, oh my goodness, I could have been happy with somebody else and I stayed for money, and money could have come to me again, or something like that. It's just difficult, very difficult times that women need to do a lot of thinking about this and never give up, never have low self-esteem, and at the same token, whatever they do, they need to you need to think carefully and plan accordingly. You cannot say, oh, I'm going to another state and God is going to help me and that's it, and just like have a blind faith and just go. No, plan your things in a way, you know, be organized and get advice, see if you can get a lawyer or you know. So these are for me many reasons I think of, that I can think of, that why abused women continue to stay in a bad relationship. Now, if you recognize yourself or you know someone who is in a similar situation, please don't give up. There is always hope. You know, you just need to put something in your mind and then take it from there. If you say to yourself, I'm going to do it, I can do it, and you're going to see that little by little things are going to work out for you. But you need to take a step at a time, and this whole thing is a big step, and you cannot just imagine that today you're here and tomorrow you're going to be somewhere completely different. It just doesn't work that way. One step at a time, little steps, and hang in there. Never give up. Each person is unique, individual. We are created by a universal creator, and we are here for a reason. So if somebody is dragging you backwards, is holding you back, you're not going to be able to progress. If somebody is making you sick, if somebody is making you cry every night, you don't want that. There is better things for you out there. Just believe. Just believe and go on. Turn the page. So this is my advice today. I hope everybody else can join me in this conversation and put on your ideas. Send me the comments, and a person who will be in this situation and will find us, they will find hope. Thank you.